and a half minutes closer to a new year. You're tuned in to Daydream Radio, your choice to see out 1958. An eventful year. Don't worry, though. I have plenty of amazing records on the cards here tonight. So buckle up as we venture back through the ages and rediscover some timeless classics. Welcome to Daydream Radio. It is New Year's Eve, and we're counting down when the clock strikes 12.
Are you there? Hey, it's Amelia. Where are you? Snap out of it. Hey, it's Amelia. Daydreaming again? You're always wandering off with your head in the clouds. Guess you haven't had much luck on your so-called supply run. We gotta find your grandfather's place before nightfall. Get your ass back down here and we'll get back on the water. Look, I understand you wanting to get in some sightseeing, having never set foot outside of that hippy-dippy camp. Though, at least the place was somewhat civilized. Don't expect anyone or anything we meet in this place to stand on ceremony. I don't mean to nag, but whenever you're ready, sweetheart. There ain't many of us left. You'd think that'd make people want to look out for each other, but seldom is that the case. Most survivors mean trouble, and this rust bucket's giving me all the trouble I need, thanking you kindly. Damn. This nut's all but threadbare. Let's hope she doesn't die on us before we find your grandfather's place.
There you are, kid.
Oh, what took you so long? Figured you met someone at happy hour. Hurry, get back on board.
Well, thank you for gracing us with your presence. Better late than never, I guess. While you've been off playing Chief Scout, I managed to give this old girl some love. She better get us to your grandfather's. Ugh, this place gives me the heebie-jeebies. All right, I think we're close, but let's double check.
Asher, it's your grandfather, John. If you're listening to this, then no doubt, I'm long gone. But I've done my best to leave you everything I have. It's all in an apartment in Boston's North End. It's a bad bounce, but if you look for the old water tower, then head west, you'll find Picard Street. Should be a clean shot, right to the doorstep. Look for number 88, top floor. Keep your head on a swivel. This world is no picnic, but it may get a whole lot brighter if you can make it to my apartment in one piece.
All right, we gotta find that old water tower, then find that street. Picard, was it? Okay, keep your eyeballs peeled. Gander at all this. Well, looks like the morning after a big shindig at the Waldorf. I hope you weren't expecting to meet your soulmate down here, kid. Ain't much left for scavengers. There it is, the water tower. All right, let's head west. Now that's a tight squeeze. Oof, like my wedding dress. Don't even get me started on marriage. Hey, there's a street sign. What does it say? Picard Street. Great. Oh, damn, what is that? Is that a tent? Talk about a curveball. You think there are people here? No, it looks deserted, right? Yeah, there's no way people live here. There's no picture show. Anyway, let's shake a leg. Let's find 88. Kid, looks like we're in for a real shitstorm.
Who is this that means to choke our mother's realm with blackest smoke? A pair of cursed beasts! That maketh cursed beasts of oil and iron. You forfeited this world. Forfeit now your right to walk upon it. Your people will call the rats and roaches master. Even the smallest microbe will have its revenge for what you did.
Good God, what kind of freak show? What makes you so special, huh? Think your fancy dress costumes let you off the hook? Oh, hell, Crocs! Damn! Great timing! The boat won't start! Hang on to your tighty-whities, kid. I'll fix the boat. Cover me from those oversized handbags. We take too much of a beating from them and we're sunk. Wonderful. Here they come. Later, alligator. We need an exit strategy. Here, take this crowbar and crack open that old emergency kit. Gotta be something in there we can use. Oh, flare gun. Time to use it, I guess. But on what? A couple of marshmallows to roast? Wait, those barrels! Yes, shoot the damn barrels! Aces! Nice shot! You're not completely worthless, huh? Oh, there she is! Oh, you beauty! Hold on!
Rise, you from the depths! Swoop down from tree and sky! Our mother calls for the human's blood!
Continue on and be your decoy. You need to get to the apartment on foot. Make for the apartment. Stay low, keep quiet. So long. Remember. It is far easier to start something than it is to finish it. Finish it, Asher.
Security online. Please use biometric hand scanner. Stage 1. Biometric hand identification was affirmative. Now initiating stage 2. Iris recognition scanner. Stand by. Stage 2. Iris recognition. Active. Please look into iris scanner for biometric identification. Close your eyes and I'll kiss you. Tomorrow, I'll miss you. Paul McCartney, lead singer of the Stevedores.
What? Who is it? Stand and unfold yourself. Why is it so dark in here? Why can't I feel my damn protuberances? Am I? Could I be? Buried alive? Oh, what a fate to befall a man! Just like the Edgar Allan Poe tale. This pose was unreadable. Help! I'm in this confounded box. Follow my voice. Help! Get me out of here. If you can hear me, follow my voice. Think outside the box. Me specifically outside the box. Help! I'm in this confounded box. Follow my voice. Help! Well, hello. This may come across a lick familiar, but try putting me on your wrist. Ah, that's more like it. Now, Asher, is it? Your grandfather left me here for you, to be your confidant of sorts. My name is Samuel. Just call me Sam. I can tell by the blank look on your face you've got questions. Well, you can start with tapping my face. Now, as you can see, I'm no ordinary fob watch or time trinket. My maker has endowed me with the ability to read between the lines, my friend. The lines being time and space. You following? Right. Tap that storage button. For my next trick, I have the capability to give you an extra hand. Literally. Now, it seems my previous owner burdened me with a fairly substantial item. If you would be so kind as to remove it, please. Whew, that's a weight off. Certainly looks familiar, but we'll park it for now. Should you want me to carry anything for you, just hold an item above my face and let it go. I'll do the rest. Wonderful. All right. Now, for me to become your pack mule, you'll need to upgrade my clockwork. Though exactly how eludes me. Unfortunately, my mind, like that box I was in, is a bit dusty. But I have a feeling our union is fate. Now, let's see. Oh, geez, what happened? Time has been cruel to this place.
A modern electrified abode. Long forlorn. I wonder if we can get this place humming once more. Or at least get them lights on. Let's take a look around. Well, let's stop stumbling around. We need to jump. This place is walled up like a pharaoh's tomb. How about you open the curtains? Holy smokes! That's not the world I remember. Like an overgrown garden. Time has had its way with this place. Let's seize the day, my friend. And by seize, I mean let's get this place electrified. Ah, yes. The wondrous television. I suppose we can see if it's working. Let's be the powers that be. Let's take control. There must be some kind of doohickey that will kickstart this old... Hold on. Those Russian words. I think I can translate them. Congratulations to Mother Russia. First country. Huh. An old ventilation duct. No lack of fresh air in here, though. Here's a novelty, Asher. A temporal shard. Picture a traveler returning from a snowstorm. Upon arrival, he shakes the snow off his shoulders, which finds its way to the cabin floor. Well, in this case, it's time falling from our traveler's shoulders, which preserves itself in this protective shell. They make for an incredibly rare and much coveted form of temporal energy. There's value in this. Let's pocket it. Now that's a thing of beauty. Shame. Just needs a battery. Let's be the powers that be. Let's take control. There must be some kind of doohickey that will kickstart this old dwelling. Well, well, well. Aren't we a live wire? Huh. These wires look like they might be related to that locked box there. Relatively speaking, of course. Well, let's stop stumbling around. We need to jumpstart this abode.
N-
No, I don't believe it's a coaster. You don't even have a drink. But there might be something on that thing. Stranger things have happened. Oh, this door could be all that separates us from illumination. You're a bright enough spark to open a door. Try that handle thing there. As our friends across the Great Atlantic would say, this door has snuffed it. I could give her the kiss alive. That said, it'll cost me plenty in terms of my precious little energy. Tap the button just below my face, will you? I'll show you a pilot trick. The sacrifices I make. Now, if you ever lost a stock, just push that button and I'll do my best to offer you counsel. All right, if you could kindly place me back on your wrist. Would you look at that? This looks like the kind of thing we could jumpstart a small town with. Put Thor to shame. This looks promising. Fitz, our endeavor to open said door has brought this thing back from the dead. Sun catcher is what they called him. Looks like this one is missing a few pieces.